Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be an O Poly try on haul. But before we get into the video, I just want to make a quick little disclaimer because I actually ordered around 6 or 7 dresses for this video, and after I made the order and paid for the order, I got an email from O Poly basically saying that the website had false stock on the website. So it was saying dresses were in stock when they actually weren't. So I've actually ended up with 3 dresses less than I actually originally ordered, which I'm not happy about at all, but we're gonna move and we're still gonna do the video because I still do have a few little dresses for you to show you, and I have been excited to film this video. So I'm just gonna move with what we've got. We're gonna go with it and just see what we think of the dresses that I have got. Just putting that out there. Second disclaimer is today in Manchester there is a bit of sun out and the skies are blue, which means everyone, and I mean everyone, has decided to lawn mow their garden at the same time that I need to film this video. There's currently about 6 people mowing their garden outside, so if you do hear that in the background of this video, then I apologize in advance, but I'm just gonna carry on filming the video because we've not got time to wait for them to stop, so I'm sorry about that. But let's just get on to the video anyway. With O Poly dresses, normally I size up. I think everyone is sort of advised to size up unless you're really, really petite, because apparently the dresses are really small fitting. So I've got all my dresses in a size 10. We're hoping that they fit. But the first dress that I picked up is called the Irresistible Bodycon Satin Peplum Mini Dress in Hot Pink. And I love this dress. This is a dress that I've been so excited to try on, so I'm hoping it lives up to the expectation. So I've popped it on a hanger just so it's easier to show you what it actually looks like. So this is what it looks like. It's just a satin pink dress, basically a satin hot pink dress. It's got a little peplum frill detail at the bottom, and it actually goes shorter in the middle at the front and then longer at the back. It has adjustable straps at the back, which I'm actually quite happy about because it's always good just to have an adjustable strap just in case you do need to, you know, tighten it up around that area. It's got a nice invisible zip, and yeah, that's it really. It's just got a little detail going down the front here, going along the waist, so I'm hoping that's gonna, you know, give the illusion of a nice waist as well. So I'm excited to try this on. Okay, so I have the first dress on, and oh my god, I am obsessed with this dress. Just like I thought I would, I'm actually obsessed with it, and it fits perfectly, I must say. Definitely size up, because I do feel like that is the best thing to do just in case. And I feel like this material is surprisingly stretchy as well, which I'm really surprised about. When I was putting the dress on, I was a bit worried because I thought there wasn't going to be any stretch in the material at all, but they're actually surprisingly really stretchy. I've not actually adjusted these straps yet. I would have to adjust the strap because I do feel like the straps are a bit loose at the top. But other than that, I do actually love this dress. This is what it looks like on, and I really love the little peplum detail on the bottom, so this is a thumbs up from me. Okay, so the next dress that I picked up is called the Let's Be Clear Strap Ruched Mesh Mid-Axi Dress in Oyster White. O Poly, please shorten the names of your dresses because that was a mouthful. Like, I'm actually out of breath after reading that, god. So this dress is actually strapless, so I can't put it on a hanger to show you, but I'm just going to hold it up. So this is what it looks like. It's just basically a ruched white mesh dress. It's really, really, really long, and I'm not sure how I'm going to feel about this just because I am only really small, so this will probably come down to my ankles, and I'm not sure how I feel about that, but I wanted to try it just to see how I actually felt about dresses like this because I've never really wore one. It does have a little silicone sort of band in there, so obviously it's a bandeau kind of style, when you have it on, it's gonna just be really well supported and hopefully it won't fall down. It's got a ruching detail all the way down the back. It's more ruched at the back than I would say at the front, but then obviously it ruches at the sides as well. And yeah, the one thing that I have noticed is it's not got a zip, so I'm not sure how your girl's gonna get in this dress, because I've not got the smallest hips in the world, so I mean, we'll see. It does feel quite stretchy, so I'm hoping I'll be able to get that on. So I now have the Oyster White dress on, the ruched one, and obviously you're not going to be able to see the full length of this dress, and I'm not even kidding, it actually goes all the way down to my ankle, and it's basically the same size as me. For reference, I am 5'2", and this dress actually touches the bottom of my ankle where my foot begins, so I'm not too sure about this one. I think the fit of it is beautiful, the ruching material is really, really flattering, and I love the way that it's really supportive around the boob area. The silicone strip really does help it stay up, and the ruched material, like I said, does really flatter you, but I just don't think I could actually wear something this long. Like, I'm actually struggling, like, to walk in it. I've actually been waddling in this dress, so I really love this dress, but I don't think I'll be keeping this one because it is literally that tight, I can't breathe and I can't walk. So, unfortunately, I think this dress is a no from me. So the next dress that I picked up is a lemon yellow dress, which I'm also obsessed with. It's called the Midsummer Dream Satin Knee Length Dress in Lemon, and this is also a satin dress. So this is what it looks like. It's just this gorgeous lemon satin material. It's got ruching down each side, so you can see from the back there. It's got a nice invisible zip, whoops. And this has also got adjustable straps, and the little detailing of the adjustable straps are in gold, which I really like because it goes really nice with the lemon colour. It also does have a little clasp at the back where the zip is. This dress keeps falling off the hanger. I apologise for that. And then it does just have this little wired cupping detail where the boob area is, so I'm hoping that's going to be quite supportive. The one thing I will say is that cup does not actually look big enough for my boob area, so I'm hoping that when I do try the dress on, I'm not like spilling out of it or anything. The middle of the dress is just a normal satin material, and then it just ruches on either side, which I do think is going to be really flattering, so I'm hoping this fits really nice. Okay, so this is the yellow dress on. I must say it is quite booby. It does show a lot of cleavage, which I don't know how I feel about. Like I thought, the cup is a lot smaller. So this is the lemon dress on, and like I thought, the cup detail is really small. I would say it's bigger than a foot, but it's still small. I just think it's just a bit too much personally. But I do actually love this dress. So it ruches at either side, and then it's just straight down the middle. It also does have an invisible zip at the back, which is really nice, and the straps are adjustable. If the straps were fully adjusted, then you're not gonna really fall out. But I feel like my whole chest is on show, so I'm not sure how I feel about this one, but I do really love the colour and I love the style, and I do think these dresses are really worth it. It's also giving like a really nice detail on the waist, makes your waist look really nice and cinched, so I mean, we can't complain with that. So yeah, I think this dress does get a thumbs up. So this is the last dress of the little haul, and this is called the Stargazer Embellished Mini Dress in Dusky Pink. I've seen this dress on so many bloggers and so many girls on Instagram, and it looks really nice. It is quite short, so I'm hoping it's not too short. It's quite hard to show you because the back of the dress does this little thin stringy detail does actually cross over at the back, so it should actually look like that. So it's got a little zip as well, and it's also got a clasp at the back. And this dress at the front, just behind here, also does have that little silicone banding, so it's not gonna, you know, fall down or anything, which I think is really nice. And then this is the nicest part of the dress, like it has this gorgeous diamante detail that just dangles down one side of the dress, and like, that's gonna be really, really flattering. So I'm hoping that'll look really nice. And the one thing I will say is this material isn't the kind of material I thought it was gonna be. Like, I don't know how to describe that material. Like, oh my god, what is it? Oh my god, maybe I'll have to try and find out what material is. But anyway, yeah, this is the last dress, so let's hope that this looks really nice on. So this is the dress on. I hope you can see that. This is the dress on, and I'm not really keen on this one at all. I feel like the material doesn't really flatter my body type, and I do feel like it's quite big fitting. I don't know whether if I sized down in this dress it would fit better, but I just don't think the material is supportive. This dress, like, it's like that is just flapping over. It's not flattering at all. So that little silicone band actually doesn't even touch the top of my chest for it to stay there. So I don't really like this dress, to be honest, but I do feel like the design is really pretty. Like, I've seen it on other people and it does look gorgeous, but I just don't feel like this dress was made for me at all. I love the design on the side though. I feel like the diamante bits on the side are a really nice detail, but I just don't feel like it makes the dress fit well. All of the dresses that I tried on in this video. I hope, even though I didn't actually have all the dresses that I chose for this haul, that you still enjoyed it. I do really think Opoly dresses are worth buying. The material is really worth it. I do think you've got to be careful with what you buy, because some of the sizes are really hit and miss, and you do have to choose what's most flattering for your body type. You think Opoly as a brand is really worth it, and I think the dresses are beautiful. So yeah, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, because that's where I do post a lot of content as well. So I'll leave it all in the description box, and if you want to follow me on any social media, then I'll leave it there, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!